diversity of unicellular organisms. As the progression continued, annelid cells and duacutians diversified to occupy all the niches their microscopic world had to offer. The annelid cells, being smaller and less complex than the duacutians, remained at the bottom of the food chain, but the duacutians mostly became large predators. Annelid cell diversity. In this new world, full of predators, annelid cells had to find a way to either escape or reproduce faster than the duacutians, and this pressure drove the annelid cells to become two different lineages, the so-called speed cells and tank cells. The tank cells contain numerous autotrophs, while the speed cells contain fast-moving heterotrophic cells, propelled by cilia and flagella. Tank cells, as their name suggests, were very sturdy and had a hardened membrane with only a few entry points to gather nutrients, which were then broken down by sunlight in the case of autotrophs, or by reactions with absorbed chemicals in the case of chemotrophs. Speed cells were the complete opposite to tank cells, being fast and agile. They had one or multiple flagella, also powered by molecular machines, which they undulated rapidly to achieve incredibly high speeds among unicellular organisms. All speed cell species were heterotrophs, living around the ocean floor or the ocean surface, where a plentiful amount of food was always drifting by. Duacutian diversity. The first duacutians, those without the characteristic double membrane, were quickly outcompeted and went extinct, and their descendants proceeded to split into three lineages: phyla cells, chemo cells, and solvi cells. Phyla cells were heterotrophs, and their main predators of this microscopic world. They had evolved flagella similar to those of speed cells, but being bigger, they couldn't achieve such high speeds. Species with flagella all around their bodies mostly fed on tank cells near the ocean surface, while species with only three flagella on one end of their body were the main predators of speed cells and other duacutians. Chemo cells, while still being able to eat other cells and decompose the materials themselves, were mostly chemotrophs, aiding their digestion with energy provided from chemical reactions. While they didn't have flagella, as it wasn't necessary, they did have small cilia all around their outer membrane to rotate or slowly move from place to place. All chemo cells lived on the bottom of the ocean, as they relied on chemicals provided by hydrothermal vents to survive. Solvi cells were the first obligate autotrophs in the duacutian lineage. They evolved after the tank cells, but they specialized in a similar niche, slowly outcompeting them as they were larger and able to collect more sunlight and stop it from getting to the cells beneath it. While predation from phyla cells and some herbivorous speed cells was always a risk, solvi cells quickly colonized the oceans, leaving the tank cells no other choice but to find another niche or go extinct.